Amulyajyoti is an organization that was founded in Pune in 1990 by the city's senior flautists such as Pandit Arvind Gajendra Gadkar, Pandit Ajit Soman, Pandit Keshav Ginde and his disciples and many other well-wishers. The name Amulyajyoti was inspired by and derived from Amal Jyoti, which was the original name of Pandit Pannalal Ghosh. A doyen of Indian flautists, Pannababu popularized the flute as a classical concert instrument. He was also a great innovator. He did fundamental research on the flute and introduced new features in its structure and properties. He conceived and devised a bamboo flute that was longer than the traditional flute in vogue till then. It has been the objective of Amulyajyoti to commemorate Pannababu's memory and carry forward his legacy by propagating and promoting the cause of the flute. On the other hand, following in his footsteps, Amulyajyoti also seeks to conduct further research on the flute and to raise awareness about it in the public mind by various means. Amulyajyoti has come a long way in the 27 years since it was founded. To begin with, it started organizing a one-day Pannalal Ghosh Memorial Music Festival. The first such festival was held at the Mahatma Phule Hall, Kumthekar Road, Pune in 1990. Over the years, a large number of established as well as upcoming artists from different gharanas, flautists and other instrumentalists as well as vocalists have performed in this festival. These include flautists Pandit Devendra Murudeshwar, Anand Murudeshwar, Pandit Raghunath Seth, Pandit V. G. Karnad, Pandit Arvinda Gajendra Gadkar, Pandit Nityanand Haldipur, Pandit Ronu Mazumdar, Pandit Rajendra Prasanna, Pandit Rajendra Kulkarni, sitarists Pandit Arvind Parikh, Ustad Usman Khan, harmonium player Pandit Appa Jalgaonkar, santur player Dr. Dhananjay Daithankar, violinists Pandit Atul Kumar Upadhyay, Ustad Fayyaz Hussain Khan, Shehnai Sundri players Ramesh Khadatkar, Kalyan Apar, vocalists Pandit Sharad Sathe, Ustad Saiduddin Dagar, Pandit Vijay Sardeshmukh, Pandit Prakash Sangeet, Pandit Shaunak Abhisheki, Pandita Suhasini Koratkar, Pandit Uday Bhavalkar, Pandita Bharati Vaishampayan, Pandita Manjiri Alegaonkar. Originally, the festival used to begin with a performance by an upcoming flautist, followed by the performance of an established vocalist or instrumentalist. And it used to end with the performance of a renowned flautist. This sequence got modified over time. Apart from the performance of an upcoming flautist, a new concept was thought of. A flute orchestra comprising a number of trained disciples and upcoming flautists presenting various innovative compositions. These compositions included Rituranga, Malhar Sagar, Kalyan Navranga Sagar, 9 ragas, and Kalyan Navranga Sagar, 25 ragas, Ananda Sagar, Venu Abhanga Ranga, Venu Natya Ranga, and Venu Sarang. The audience has welcomed all these innovations. They were conceptualized and presented by the noted flautist Pandit K. L. Ginde. There was another important benefit too. Earlier, only a few specific ragas like Hamsadhwani, Bhoop, Durga, etc. used to be played on the flute. But these innovative compositions, played and presented by a number of artists in a flute orchestra, brought forth the limitless potential of the flute as an instrument. And consequently, both the disciples, the artists of the future, and the audience became aware of it and could better appreciate it. Thus, this has proved to be an important platform for upcoming artists to perform. To encourage them further, Amulyajyoti has, for the last 10 years, instituted scholarships for the young and talented flautists and tabla players. Moreover, since 2014, which was its Silver Jubilee year, Amulyajyoti has been awarding the Venu Ratna Award to a flautist who has made notable contribution to the cause of the flute. The first flautist to be given this award was Pandit Rajendra Prasanna in 2014. In 2015, it was given to Pandit Nityanand Haldipur. And in 2016, the award was given to Pandit Ronu Mazumdar. Pandit K. L. Ginde has been contemplating and researching on the flute both theoretically and in terms of practical applications for over 40 years now.
Guru ke teen lakshan bataye gaye hain. Ek to guru gyani hona chahiye. Uske baad usko kaise sikhana ye maloom hona chahiye, how to teach, and last willing to teach. Ye teenon cheeze बहुत बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है. ये तीनों में से कोई भी एक चीज नहीं हो तो गुरु के लिए लायक होता ही नहीं. आप गिंडे साहब को जो देख रहे हैं वो ये खास बात है कि शागिर्द के लिए उनके मन में जो भावना है वो बहुत कम गुरु में होती है. और गिंडे साहब उसमें से है कि जो अपने से शागिर्द को अच्छा देखना चाहते हैं. गुरु हमेशा चार चीजें बताता है. शास्त्र बताता है, एक्सप्लेन करता है, तंत्र सिखाता है, विद्या देता है और कला संस्कारित करता है. ये चार चीजें हैं जो गिंडे साहब को मैं बहुत बहुत उनका अभिनंदन कर रहा हूँ इस चीज का कि ये हमारी परंपरा को बरकरार करते रहेंगे.
On the theoretical side, he has written a major treatise in Marathi, Venu Vidnyan, on the art of playing and the craft of making a flute and innovations in the flute since Pannababu's time. This has been published by Rajhans Prakashan, Pune. In 2010, Pandit Ginde was awarded a senior research fellowship by the Ministry of Culture of the Government of India for conducting research on the flute. He has presented the results of his research in the Hindi treatise Venu Ved, which has been made available in PDF format on the website bookganga.com. By way of practical application of his ideas, emerging from his long research, Pandit Ginde has devised and prepared different types of innovative flutes, all of which go well beyond the range of the traditional flute, which has 7 holes, including the blowing hole, and can play 2 to 2.5 octaves. These innovative flutes are Keshav Venu, length a little more than 3.5 feet, 44 inches, inner diameter 1 inch, 26 millimeters, holes 12 including the blowing hole, playing range 3.5 to 4 octaves. Shri Krishna Murali, length 4 feet, inner diameter 1.25 inches, 32 millimeters, holes 9 including the blowing hole, playing range 2 to 2.5 octaves. This flute gives 4 notes below karaj. This is a new concept in flute playing. Anahata Venu, length 12 feet, inner diameter 3 inches, 75 millimeters, holes 9 including the blowing hole. This flute can play 2 octaves below the mid octave, that is bass, karaj octave, and low bass, laraj octave. Chaitanya Venu, length 1.25 inches, 32 millimeters, diameter 6 millimeters, holes 5 including the blowing hole, playing range extremely high twitter octave, can give sounds like those of birds.
मुझे बहुत सारी चीजें याद हैं उनकी. एक तो बहुत बड़े इंजीनियर होने के साथ साथ उन्होंने बांसुरी पे जो उन्होंने नए चीजें की कि मध्य सप्तक तक का उन्होंने मतलब ऑक्टव लेके आए, वो उनका बहुत अच्छा खूबी है जो आज तक किसी ने नहीं किया है. बहुत सारे एक्सपेरिमेंट करते हैं फ्लूट के बारे में, मेरे चाचा जी, मेरे पिताजी, सब लोगों ने खूब किया है, लेकिन ऑक्टेव वाला जो चीज़ है वो बहुत मुश्किल था, उन्होंने किया है, उसके लिए उनको मैं धन्यवाद करता हूँ.
इन द मेकिंग ऑफ द अनाहत वेणु एंड चैतन्य वेणु, पंडित गिंडेज डिसाइपल अजहरुद्दीन शेख ऑल्सो मेड अ नोटेबल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन. The essential features of these different flutes can be seen at a glance. Keshav Venu, Anahat Venu, and Chaitanya Venu have a total playing range of 7 octaves. Each of them has been either certified or recognized by different record books. Keshav Venu, this has been certified by Research and Development Section of the Guinness Book of World Records and recognized by the Limca Book of Indian Records and the Golden Book of World Records. Anahata Venu, this has been recognized by the Golden Book of World Records and the Limca Book of Indian Records. Chaitanya Venu, this has been recognized by the Golden Book of World Records and the Limca Book of Indian Records to be the smallest flute in the world.
सेवा ये कर रहे हैं, इससे बड़ा सेवा कुछ हो ही नहीं सकता है. जिन्होंने बांसुरी को जन्म दिया, जन्मदाता को याद करना सभी बांसुरी वालों का कर्तव्य है, और वो कर्तव्य दादा से अच्छा कोई नहीं निभा रहा है पूरे विश्व में.
This journey of Amulyajyoti is now nearing the 3-decade mark. All this while, it has been generously supported by conjurers, donors and music-loving entrepreneurs from Pune as well as other places, by the founder members and their families, by disciples, as also by the Maharashtra Executor and Trustee Company Limited, Bank of Maharashtra and the Center of Fine Arts, Savitribai Phule, Pune University. Ordinary flute lovers have also been kind in extending their support. This all-round support and the blessings of discerning audience would continue to inspire Amulyajyoti in its journey ahead.